In a recent video, we looked at how Darth Vader was able to discover the name of Luke Skywalker, and of course the connection between them, after Vader interrogated a captured rebel pilot named Thurlow Harris on the planet of Centaurus. But while Vader would learn for the first time that he had a son, and would immediately begin his plans to ally with Luke to destroy the Emperor by eliminating anyone who may have also heard the name of Skywalker, there was a moment when Vader believed his future with Luke was shattered, learning the unthinkable news that Luke was executed in the aftermath of Episode 4. Following the Rebel victory in the Battle of Yavin, Rebel General Jand O'Donna would provide Luke with a mission that would see him travel to the planet of Jasbina to attempt to bring the world onto the side of the rebellion. Given that the planet was supported by its sale of ore to the Empire, it wasn't going to be an easy task. Meeting with Jasbina's ruler, Lord Pripridenko, Luke would quickly learn the difficulty of the mission, with the Lord explaining the population didn't trust the rebellion. While Luke promised the Empire would eventually fall, despite the Lord's hesitation in ever seeing the planet switch over to the rebellion, he had an idea. His daughter, the Princess Syaina, had been kidnapped, and if she was saved, the warrior who aided in her rescue would become a hero to the population of the planet, and could change the way they saw the rebellion. After learning this, Luke agreed to rescue the princess to try to complete his mission and bring Jasbina to the rebellion. As Luke met with the ruler of the planet, Vader would soon learn of Luke's location. Knowing he now had a son, but didn't know where to begin in his search for him, Vader's stormtroopers would fortunately learn from a disgruntled rebel pilot on the planet of Dubrava, who grew jealous of Luke's reputation following the destruction of the Death Star, that Luke was on Jasbina. With that, Vader would travel to the planet immediately. To rescue Syaina, Luke was taken to the entrance of a mine so he might attack her captors from behind, and provided with a droid named 3DVO, who would record Luke's heroic deed as proof of the rebellion's good intentions. Ultimately, it would be revealed that the Lord had no intention of switching the planet's allegiance from the Empire to the rebellion. After Luke was attacked by a mining worm, only escaping after delivering a killing blow with his lightsaber, Luke would stumble upon the princess and what appeared to be her captors. While Luke sprang into action to rescue her, defeating every last one of them, it's only then that Luke would learn his error, with the princess revealing the captors were actually rebels who opposed the Empire on Jasbina. Even more, she wasn't captured, but went with them to try to persuade her father to switch allegiances. At that point, watching everything transpire through the transmission captured by the droid 3DVO, the Lord sent his own forces into the mine to capture Luke and his daughter, making it clear he was still loyal to the Empire and only using Luke to find and destroy the rebels on Jasbina. We then see that Vader was in the planet's orbit, transmitting a message to the Lord that he was on his way to the planet's surface. Importantly, it was the droid 3D who confronted the Lord first, furious to have been unknowingly used as part of what they considered an act of war in helping to capture Luke and the princess, taking very seriously their journalistic integrity and wondering how it could be possible to function without proper data. The Lord was silent, simply telling the droid not to worry about it and ordering 3D to relay Vader's message. 3D then explained Vader was on a secret mission hidden from the Empire concerning Luke. But most importantly, still angry that they were made to function unwittingly in the act of capturing Luke, when the Lord asked what Darth Vader commanded, 3D lied and looked to gain some amount of revenge by telling him Vader ordered the Lord to ensure Luke was dead by the time he landed. Having Luke already captured, the Lord saw an easy way in which to gain Vader's favor, and went to carry out the false order. As 3D was joyful, the Lord would now be operating himself without proper data. When the Lord went to his daughter with the news, she immediately offered to execute Luke herself with her own blaster, running to the dungeons under the guise that Luke should be dispatched quickly and effectively. When her father asked why she changed her allegiance and was now so willing to execute a hero of the rebellion, she told him he must have been right all along, since Vader was now personally traveling to the planet. With that, the princess raised her blaster and shot Luke in the chest from close range, telling her father to go meet with Vader as she took care of Luke. The Lord then went to welcome Vader to Jasbina, going so far as to refer to him as a great Lord of the Sith and attempting to flatter him to gain Vader's favor. But Vader would have none of it, instead wanting Luke to be brought to him immediately. At that point, believing he followed Vader's orders, the Lord then joyfully boasted that Luke had been executed as Vader commanded, resulting in a furious Vader to slowly order the Lord to repeat what he said. Learning Vader hadn't ordered such action, and confused over how the message could have been false, the Lord could only plead for Vader to show him mercy. Of course, Luke would survive, as it's revealed the princess only shocked him with a paralyzing blast. But while they would succeed in escaping the dungeon and the city altogether, they would soon bring their attention to a holotransmission, learning the fate of her father and the wrath unleashed upon him by Vader. Broadcast by 3DVO, who was guilty over his betrayal, we see the Lord was arrested and physically broken by Vader and his stormtroopers. Chained within the planet's dungeons, the Lord was able to broadcast his final goodbye to his daughter. But Vader would soon discover the secretly broadcasted message and order his stormtroopers to first destroy 3DVO and then execute the Lord. Ultimately, although he would learn that Luke was still alive and on the planet, Vader's fury against the ruler of Jasbina would unintentionally cause the entire planet to rise up against the Sith Lord, deeply troubled by his actions despite their loyalty to the Empire, which we'll discuss in an upcoming video. So there we have it, how Vader was falsely led to believe that Luke was executed after Episode 4. Thank you very much to all of the Patreon members of Star Wars Reading Club, as your support is so greatly appreciated. You can find all of our social media links and a link to our Star Wars gaming channel in the description below for updates and even more Star Wars content. We love making these videos, so why not subscribe for more fun Star Wars theories and discussions? Also, if you enjoyed the video, think about giving a like or leaving a comment. If not for me... for 3DVO.